Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Ladies and gentlemen, let's continue our tutorials about computational fluid dynamics, CFD. In this video, we're going to talk about carrying out two simulations. The first one is about vertical axis wind turbine, but it is going to be a 3D simulation. And the other simulation is going to be about a turbine ventilator. Okay, let's take a look on the turbine. I carried out a 2D analysis and I uploaded it a couple of months ago. Can find it on my YouTube channel. I used the sliding mesh technique. It's very appropriate for this kind of simulations or analysis. Here, this is my full tutorial about vertical X1 turbine using the sliding mesh, and here is another presentation about the boundary layer control. Gentlemen, now we're gonna talk about the 3D analysis. I'm not gonna use the enclosure method because I think it's really complex, and you will face many problems if you use it. So we're gonna use another technique. Now, if your turbine is something like that, just you wanna extrude the 2D surface. And it's not complex like this. Okay, so here is the extrude command. If you want to use CFX or Fluent, you have to import the flow only, not the the turbine body. I'm not gonna analyze the turbine body. No, I wanna analyze the fluid that flow over the blades. So we're gonna extrude this. It's gonna be 50 millimeter. Now it's 500 millimeter, half meter, a turbine. So this is the rotor. Okay, notice that now we have the flow around the turbine. This is the airfoils of the turbine, and I wanna investigate the flow, not the blades themselves. So here, this is the rotor. And this turbine, notice that we have two diameters. The first diameter is 1400 millimeters. This is the rotor diameter, and this is the radius, and here is 3500 millimeters. This is the diameter of the rotating domain, so be careful. Okay, this is the rotor. I'm gonna import it or save it, export as CAT format. It's gonna be a stub file. Stub file. Like that. Save. Okay, let's open Ansys. But before we begin, have something many here is a research paper, a detailed aerodynamic design and analysis of a 2D vertical X1 turbine using sliding mesh in CFD. It's very important to check out the research papers. Here, the 3D model of the turbine. This paper is available on Google. And here are the mesh and the boundary conditions. And here the unstructured mesh. It's important to know the difference between the structured and the unstructured mesh. But if you use the unstructured mesh, you have to make the layer around the surface structure to capture the boundary layer if you wanna this. And here are the results of the CM, the performance. Okay, a measured independent study. And here are the realizable capsule and turbines model, RNG, and standard capsule model. To know the difference between all of them, just open Ansys Theory, Ansys Fluent Theory Guide, and here is the standard capsule model, and an overview. And this is RNG, K epsilon, and the realizable. And here are the realizable. Both realizable RNG capsule models have shown substantial improvements over the standard capsule, where the flow features include strong streamline curvature, vortices, and rotation. So we're going to use realizable. And for more, you have to read this about the fluid dynamics or the flow fluid aerodynamics, the separation and the turbine boundary layer and the laminar boundary layer. So it's preferred to delay the separation for the aerofoil wings. And please watch this video. It's very important to know these basics. Okay, here let's open a new project. Let's create a new project. Just drag this. Here are the XY plane. Please be careful when you import the geometry. It has to be this preferred to be at the origin. Okay, notice that we have to make this add frozen or add material. But if you make it add frozen, the fixed domain has to be add material, and if this is add material, the fixed domain has to be add frozen to make it sliding mesh. Then generate. This is add frozen. Notice that we imported the flow around the airfoils. Notice that the airfoils are hollow. Okay. That's why we created Boolean in the 2D analysis. We created Boolean between the rotating domain and the airfoil body to make it hollow. Okay, now we have to create the fixed domain. So we're gonna use X, Y and units in millimeters and create new sketch. And constraints, all auto constraints, cursor, okay, draw is very important to make this. Now we have to just draw a rectangle, and to put some dimensions. And then horizontal. Okay. So let's make this very important to know that this is a random dimensions. It is a tutorial to save the computational time, but for the domain, the fixed domain, you have to follow exactly the research papers here. Notice that the domain here, this is the domain. It is a very big domain, and here the domain is not, I think that it does not represent an experimental study inside a wind tunnel. So the wall, the walls of the fixed domain will be treated as zero shear. We are not gonna use no slip conditions. Here are zero shear. But I think if the wind turbine, it was an experimental study and you have to validate the results, and the experiment was carried out inside a small wind tunnel, I think that you have to take care of the no slip conditions of the wall. But here, this is not, there is no slip condition here, zero shear. Okay, here this is a very big domain, but we're not gonna use this to save the mesh cells. Okay, it's just a tutorial, you have to increase this domain. Okay, now we're gonna extrude this sketch. Notice that you have to make it add material, and it's gonna be 500. Generate. Okay, so here is the fixed domain, but I did a mistake. You have to extrude this. Sorry. Notice that this, there is a material here, and we don't want this. So delete this and the sketch. You have to draw a circle with the same diameter of. With the same diameter of the rotating domain, take some dimensions. The diameter of the rotating domain is 3005. So now let's extrude only before this. We have to. Okay, let's extrude it. To see what will happen. Yes, this is right. Notice that we only extruded this without the circle. And here we have the target. Okay. Okay, this is very good. According to your research, you have to change the dimensions of the fixed domain, and that's according to the design of the rotating blades. Okay, let's close this. You said in the case of the turbines that the blades are, the 3D blades are created by extrude like this. And the next part of this tutorial, we're going to talk about the complex shapes, but on a turbine ventilator. Notice that we did not, we haven't created any enclosure. We did not follow the enclosure method. We just extruded the surface. Okay, now here we have, notice that we have two bodies, this body and this body. So the mesh, gonna make it fine. But for meshing, you have to follow the standards of the mesh. Here I will not take care of the mesh. I'm sorry, we have a problem here. Okay, unable to get the model. Please save your project to save the data. Right click, reset this. Okay, let's reopen it, and you have to calculate the Y plus. The benefits of this method that the skewness will be an acceptable limit. When you wrote the mesh, sizing, make it fine, and you have to read about everything here. We'll make smoothing and then generate mesh. Okay, for the aerodynamic simulations or the flow around airfoils, you have to carry out some calculations, like the Y plus calculator. according to Reynolds number, here we're gonna make the U-infinity 5, this is the wind speed, and this is according to the temperature. We're gonna use this and this, and here the reference length will be the cord. Our cord here is 0.5 meter, and the Y plus. What is the desired Y plus? You can use the Y plus according to the analysis. So we're gonna use K epsilon model. K epsilon model here is, there is a range for K epsilon model. Okay. Okay, it's okay that Y plus is not too very small. And here is from 100 or 200, or it may be between 330 to 200. So it's according to K epsilon, it is not recommended to be lower than 30. You can find out any reference that talks about this. So we're gonna make the K epsilon model or the Y plus 50. Then compute wall spacing. So this is the Reynolds, and here is the delta. It's gonna be 3 millimeters. 0.1. This is the wall spacing. Okay, here is the our mesh. I'm gonna figure out what's going on. Notice that we have here the elements are very high. So let's check out the skewness. It's 0.94, and this is acceptable, but here is the maximum skewness. So this is a very good mesh. Fluent accept the skewness not higher than 0.98. So this mesh, for this tutorial, I mean this, for this tutorial only, not for the research. For the research, you have to increase the elements near to the surface. Notice that this is very bad mesh, a very bad mesh. So the Y plus now is 50, and according to this data, you have to make the first layer thickness 3 millimeters to get the desired result. So here the first thickness is around 0.1. Notice that the first layer thickness varies due to the shape, and here we have 25 millimeters. So the minimum it has to be 3 millimeters as minimum. That's why this mesh is not suitable for our boundary conditions, but to save the time of the tutorial, we're gonna use it. Or these elements are very high, and we're gonna make it coarse. I just tell you to follow this restrictions, not this. Okay, let's generate and see. Oh, we have here a problem in the accuracy of the mesh, so we're gonna make it medium. It's a very bad mesh, it's a terrible, terrible mesh. You have to generate a verify mesh around the surface exactly like this. But here the 2D analysis is simpler. For the 2D analysis, I carried out a finer mesh, because the 2D analysis is requires lower. Okay, here we have this. Here, look at the skewness. Skewness is better, and here are the elements. This is a structured mesh for the fixed domain, an unstructured mesh, but for the 3D analysis, prefer to make the rotating domain structured to avoid this problem. Okay. I showed you this, but we have to now create out the part. The important part is to name selection. I read only, so we have to close it. Just update. I'm gonna show you another simulation to save the time, and it is better than this. But after the name selection procedure, because I carried out the simulation and I have the results. So let's open the mesh. And now select the fixed domain, right click, hide all other bodies, and here right click, fixed domain, and select face. This face is gonna be the interface rec 1, interface 1, and here is the inlet. Create name selection. This is inlet. And here the outlet. Right click. This is the outlet. Show all bodies and select the rotating domain, right click, hide all other bodies. Okay, right click, and so right click, and this is the rotating domain. And here the face. This face is gonna be the interface number 2. And for the performance curves or the performance analysis, you have to select the face, internal face of the airfoil, foil 1, and airfoil 2. Create name selection, airfoil 2, and airfoil 3. Okay, and show all bodies. Now we have the fixed and rotating domain with the name selections. Inlet, outlet, rotating, fixed, interface 1, 2, airfoil 1, 2, 3. Okay. Close the mesh. Then update it. Notice that the Y plus is according to the external flow, or it's gonna be internal flow. The internal flow has a different procedure, like the centrifugal pumps or the radial turbines or any flow or the flow inside pipes. But here I think this is for the airfoils and the flat. Plate band relayer theory computes the height of the first mesh cell of the wall required to achieve a desired Y plus using flat plate band relayer theory. So here the calculator is according to the flat plate. You have to find another empirical equation, like I said, like this. I think that. Okay, for another calculations for the Y plus, notice that the Y plus depends on the model. So the calculator here is according to a flat plate. But we have to calculate the airfoil Y plus. So you have to find out research papers or many things. Investigation of band relayer suction on a wind turbine airfoil using CFD. This is a thesis. And the our target is to calculate the Y plus. Here are the band relayer theory. And here are the separation and very important concepts, expression bubbles, according due to the adverse pressure and the stall, and here the flap. So at 44-45, here we have the empirical equation. Okay, present report by target Y plus value given the Reynolds number and a reference length. Here's the first layer thickness using the formula delta Y equal L delta Y plus root 80 Reynolds to the power minus 13 to divided by 14. So this is an empirical equation. They used it after the first layer is created thicker layers, the height of the which is defined by the expansion factor. And here the expansion factor at the mesh. In Ansys, you will find the expansion factor. You can make it 1.2 or 1.1. It's according to the recommendations of the research. So you can use the empirical equations that is suggested by the researchers. And here, point-wise is for the flat plate. So it's according to the accuracy and according to the analysis. Okay, no problem. Let's open the setup. And it's preferred to use the equations, empirical equations. Here, double precision, if your mesh is according to the calculations, and Perl, here you can set the number of your cores, but I'm gonna use it serial because I have here another processing. The double precision is preferred at when the high accuracy is required. This kind of simulations are transient simulation due to the behavior of the flow, K epsilon, and realizable, and enhanced wall treatment for the to get the accuracy. And the material is gonna be air, and you have to fill this formation according to your model. And here the rotating domain, air, and mesh motion. This is the sliding mesh concept, and here is the origin. Okay, and if your origin 000 and the rotation axis 001, and here the speed, the rotational velocity, our turbine. The velocity of the wind is 5, so we divide 5 by the radius of the rotor. So I think the rotor here is the rotor radius, is 1400. Okay, so here it's gonna be 3.57 radian per second. This is the rotational speed, and the fixed domain is gonna be air, no mesh motion. Okay, the boundary conditions from the inlet velocity, inlet here the velocity 5, and intensity, the turbulence intensity according to the references for these kind of simulations is around 0.01. You can change it as you like, but you have to read the research papers and the recommendations and how to get the turbulence intensity. For the hydraulic diameter here in meter, it's going to be the chord length. Our chord is 0.5 meter, and also for the outlet, zero gauge pressure outlet, and you may change this, but I'm gonna make it like it, like the previous, and backflow is the cord. Please, you have to read about this to make sure of everything. Many of the mission interfaces, they are created automatically, not like the 2D. And here is the trick. The reference values, gentlemen, affects the CP and the CM and lift and drag force, drag coefficients. So, this is a very important concept. How to calculate, how to resolve negative torques, torque values for a vertical axis wind turbine. How you can read this article or this question. Here he has a problem with the torque, and you can read this. So the reference values, so it's recommended for the area in the 2D problems, the area is going to be relative diameters according to this researcher. And for the 3D, the rotor diameter multiplied by the blade height. Okay, so let's make this. The area here is what? The area here. It's going to be the cord length multiplied by the thickness of the rotor or the height of the turbine, 0.5 meter times 0.5 meter. So it's quarter square meter, but this is for one airfoil. So the question is, here is the area of the rotor diameter. Here the rotor diameter multiplied by the blade height. So I multiplied the blade height, but I did not multiply it by the rotor diameter. I multiplied it by the chord. So you have to make sure that this is right and to find out the experimental values. So please try this method, and you have to compare your numerical results against the experimental results to be sure of everything. So my method here is multiplying the chord by the height of the turbine, and then multiplied by the number of the blades. You can use this, and you can check out this method, and it's according to the experimental results. Okay. So the area here is going to be 0.75. Okay, for the three blades, because we the reference values. I'm not sure, guys, but okay, let's make it 0.0, because it is reference values. Gonna be 2.5. Okay, so I think that we may use this. So the rotor diameter, 1.4. It's gonna be 0.7, okay? Gentlemen, this is proves that my my approach is nearly right. So the area is gonna be 0.7 or 0.75. This is good. So we have here the method, the rotor diameter multiplied by blade height. The rotor diameter is 1.4 meter and multiplied by the height 0.5 and 0.7. And my method tells me that the area is 0.75, so it's no problem. And here the density and no enthalpy and no heat transfer. And here is the length. Length here, I think that the length is, according to this researcher, the cord length. Okay, yes, I'm gonna use the cord length 0.5. Okay, and I think the velocity is gonna be 5. You may make it 1 and check out the results. So this solution methods, for a higher accuracy, you have to make sure you have to read about the scheme and the gradient, the pressure, second order, first order. You have to change these settings according to the mesh accuracy and the references. And here the solution controls. For the monitors, if you increase the zeros, here you will have higher accuracy results, and the time will increase. So now we're gonna create drag, print to console, plot, and write, and the axis is gonna be Y, apply, close. This is for airfoil 1, the drag, create, drag, for airfoil 2, and the axis, okay, and create drag, the console, plot, write, to find the text file after finishing the results, airfoil 3, left, right, X is Y for airfoil 1, create, left, airfoil 2, create left, for airfoil number 3, and for the moment you can monitor the CM value for every airfoil and for the airfoils together. Moment, airfoil 2, plot, right, okay, create moment, airfoil 3, print to console, right, okay, now the most important thing is to make CM for the whole turbine blades. This is the total CM. And here, hybrid initialization or standard, you can read about the difference and initialize. Notice that the initialization tells you that the convergence will, it's gonna take time here because the mesh is big. Two, notice that the minus 4 the power to the minus 4 is a very good convergence. So here the initialization or the initial values are very good, and the solution is gonna be convergent. If these values are no are minus 3 or minus 2 to the power minus 3 or to the power minus 2, the convergence will not occur. Okay, the hybrid initializer is done, and I'm gonna calculate the activities. For the animation files, you have to make autosave every 1 or 10 or 100 up to it's up to the disk space. So make it 1 for the animation. Check case, you have to check the case. Yeah, check your mesh because the accuracy is not good. And the server consider higher order discretization, yes, but we're gonna use this. And time steps, here you have to calculate the X wind turbine model. You have to calculate the time step is according to the model and the rotational speed. We have here 2D analysis. Notice that here the fixed domain is very big. I forgot something. For the boundary conditions, the wall of the fixed domain edit and make the specified shear 0 and rotating domain specified shear 0. And you have to check out these settings. You can make, I think that you can make node slip if you have a wind tunnel, but I'm not sure of this. And also the rotating domain. But I think that's recommended to make it specified shear 0. Because the if you have a flat plate and flow over a flat plate or inside a fixed pipe, you have to make the no slip conditions. If the flow around the cylinder or sphere or an airfoil, it has to be zero shear. For the airfoils, yes, no slip conditions to check out the boundary layer. If you make this specified, this is not true, it's not right. For the walls of the airfoils, no slip conditions. Okay. Yes, no slip, but the other rotating domain or fixed domain specified shear is 0. Okay. Here for the notice that unstructured grid and around the airfoil there is the layers. Okay, to capture the boundary layer. And here the turbine intensity is 0.1. This is according to this resource. And here is the setting. And notice that for order A. And here is the rotational speed. And they calculated the time step according to it. First attempt value for order B was delta T equal 3 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 4. So you have to carry out the calculations. And here we're gonna use this. Let's make it 2000 and maximum iterations is gonna be 50. This increases the accuracy. Ansys is gonna use 50 iteration per the time step as a trial and error. And if you increase the maximum iteration per time step, it's gonna be okay, or the accuracy will be higher than if you use 20 or 30. Then calculate. Okay. So the reference area, if you decrease the reference area, the you find the CM value increases, because the there is an adverse relationship between them. And here calculating the solution. I showed in the 2D tutorial how to make animation files in Fluent. And here I'm gonna tell you the method of the animations from the CFD post. And here are the conversions. It's gonna be very slow. I'm sorry, I'm running another simulation about smoke management. And also the smoke management, you have to read the research papers to know the concept behind smoke management systems and smoke layer height and something like that. CFD actually is not straightforward. So if this simulation is faster, you're gonna see that this convergence will be will reach many steps in short time. Okay, let's cancel this, and I'm gonna show you the other simulation. I have finished it already. But you have to follow the same procedure, just change the dimensions and the required data. We'll find the text files of the results in the file or the folder FFF of the model. Here is the solution. Of the other simulation. I followed the same procedure. Notice that here is the convergence. It's very good conversion, but the accuracy of the mesh is not good, and you have to carry out another mesh. So this is the convergence after many iterations. Okay, cancel. Let's now check out the results. you can change this to the monitors of the CM of the values, and you can open reports and choose the forces. Okay, let's talk about it. Okay, here the reports. Okay, reports, forces, setup, moments. We wanna the moments of the turbine, so check choose the airfoil 1, 2, and 3. And the moment center 000, and here the moment axis 0, and here this 1. Then print here the at this time step, or at this time, this is the net, it's gonna be negative, and here the viscous, here the pressure, and here the pressure coefficient of this turbine at this time step. So you have to check out the monitor. The monitor will tell you the history of the values like this. Here, if you carry out the monitor like what I showed now, you will find that this CM values changes, and you will find negative values at some time, and you have to, I think that you have to take the average and then calculate the other parameters. Notice that you have, may get negative, but the average is going to be positive. And here is the performance curves, the performance coefficient, like that. Okay, gentlemen. Results. Here is our model. Check out the contours. This is the fixed domain contour, rotating domain. Here is the wall of it. Okay, and the vectors, the velocity, fixed domain, vectors of the rotating domain, of the wall. Notice you can change the make the reduction factor over here 100, 1000, notice here the if you do not make Boolean, you will find that they're just a flow around a sphere or a cylinder, not rotating airfoils. Notice that here is the look. It's very interesting. This is the turbine. And for the animations, you have to find these time steps, and here is the time steps. Let's take a look. Note the 3D rotor turbine. The contours change with time. To save this movie, you have to check save movie and to locate the place. And then click play to save it as a separate file movie file. Okay, to save time, we're gonna stop it. Stop it. Save movie, you have to check this. Vector 1, vector 2, and you have my the streamlines, fixed domain, maximum points. Notice. Rotating domain. Here is the streamlines around the 3D chip. Also, you can make animation for these streamlines here, one or two. Okay, Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we have just finished the first part of this tutorial about the vertical axis wind turbine. Now we're going to talk about another technique for another model. Okay, let's close the banner. Here is a turbine ventilator research paper experimental and safety analysis of turbo ventilator, and here is the three-dimensional model of turbo ventilator, and here is the enclosures as you know. It is installed on the roof of the house, and here is the stagnation conditions for ventilation. Here is the air out, and here is the plenum chamber, and here the wind velocity. You can find out okay, turbine ventilator. There is a great video about the turbine ventilator function. Yeah, turbine ventilator. It's very interesting to work on these simulations. Please check out these interesting models and videos. Okay, I have here a model of my friend. This is not my design. He sent it to me okay, let's import it, create the project. And here is the analysis. They use the K epsilon model and realizable, I think. And here is the enclosure for the air. This is the wind, the air of the wind on the roof, and here the chamber under the roof or beneath it. Okay, let's open geometry. The problem was that we are not able to carry out the simulation like the research paper due to the enclosure method. The enclosure method used the enclosure method, but it did not work properly. So we're gonna use another technique. Here is the design of my friend. Good job. Okay. As you see, this is the blades, the 3D blades, not the flow around the blades. Okay, so now we're gonna show you how to fix this. Millimeters, import external geometry file, move the vent, add frozen, yes. Here is the turbine blades. So now we have to carry out some body transform body operations to generate the flow around the blades. I do not care about the blades. This is not a structural analysis or a stress analysis. This is a fluid analysis. So this is the sketch. Sketch here. The circle. This circle is the retaining domain. Then okay, after drawing the this sketch, we have to extrude it exactly with the thickness of the height of the blades. Apply, and it's gonna be add material, and here it's gonna be this is the height, exactly the height generate. If this height is larger or higher than the height, you're gonna not find this the blades. Now the tricky is that we have to hollow the blades. We only have to find the flow around it. So just create body operation, cut material. This is the trick, and apply and preserve it. Yes, then please suppress this body. Okay, here we are, guys. Now we have the blades, but hollow blades like what we did in the vertical axis with turbine, but this is according to your design. Okay, so if you have a complex design, just create the rotor and extrude it. If the import is add frozen, please extrude the rotor as add material, and then cut make body, and then cut material, and choose the vent and preserve it, and then suppress it just like the mold. Okay, so this is our turbine. Now you can carry out the simulation. Now we're gonna complete the tutorial, new sketch for the fixed domain. I'm gonna draw a random rectangle for the fixed domain. It's gonna represent this. Okay. Then extrude sketch number 5 with the same, or you yes, we're gonna make it the same. I'm sorry, but you before this, like we did the sketch 5, we have to draw the circle tangent, and then extrude the sketch in the same. It's gonna be add frozen for the sliding mesh. This is very important. Okay, here we go. Now we have our turbine ventilator. Notice the number of we have the vent, but we do not need it. We have two domains. Solid, this is the retaining domain. Okay, no problem. few suppress this or hide this of the interface. This sounds good. Show all bodies, but please you have to unsuppress this vent. If you do not suppress it, the blades that were carried out on the SolidWorks will appear, and we do not need this. Okay, now we have to, if you want to carry out this the same procedure, notice that we only carried out the fixed domain and up to this point. We, if you want to increase it, just do this, create XY plane, new plane, and with the same extrude, delete it, where the extrude, I need this, copy it, and go to the XY and create XY plane. And we have to make this offset from Z with the same height. Generate. Now we have another plane. We'll just start it from here. And this plane, new sketch. Okay, it's gonna be the same rectangle without the circle. Okay. Okay, to be sure of this, check out the dimensions. Just copy this. Okay. Okay. And the thing is, make vertical dimensions. Yes. This is V10. Which is X. And dimensions vertical. This is V3. Okay. Now we have exactly dimensions. But for the horizontal dimensions, H11. Yes. Then extrude the last sketch as you like. This is as you like. Then generate. Notice that we have to make it exact like this. This is at frozen, so it's gonna be at frozen. Yes, to be act like one body. Okay, here for the ventilation pipe, we have to draw it. So from the sketch, this sketch, we're gonna use another sketch for the ventilation pipe. And here, so let's take a look on the drawing. And here is the okay, the ventilation pipe. This we're gonna check out its dimensions. Yes, this is the back, and yes, so small dimensions. And millimeters. Okay. So we're gonna draw circle from here and the dimensions. Okay. Here. Okay, this is the ventilation pipe, and we're gonna extrude it. Sketch number 7. It's gonna be at frozen. Sorry. It's gonna be at material. I'm sorry. This is at frozen. This is at frozen. Yeah, yes, at frozen, like the fixed domain. We add frozen, and here the length of the pipe. So we're gonna assume it, or make it as you like according to your model. So we're gonna make it like this, but it's not in the normal direction, it will be reversed. Okay, then generate. So we have here inlet. This is the pipe for ventilation, and here the rotating domain and fixed domain. Notice that sum up, import as frozen, and then extrude as material, and another extrude as frozen, extrude as frozen, extrude as frozen. The fixed domains are frozen. Okay. Gentlemen, okay, let's close this. Let's open the mesh. Like I said, I'm gonna create a random mesh, but you have to follow the standard procedure for the sizing and the boundary layer and the issues like this. Generate this mesh, and I'm gonna show you the other. Okay. Sorry, this is because I have parallel processing. Reset. Generate. Notice that the procedure of generating the mesh without the inclusion method is very simple. And here the sizing is very it's a random mesh. And the statistics. And the skewness. Lower size gives you a better skewness. And here, make it fine. Here, the skewness. Not that the skewness is better for the small size. Okay, here's the other hide other bodies. It's gonna be inlet one. Okay, and here is the outlet. And notice that this is the inner face one. And okay, show all bodies. And this, and other bodies, this. Fixed domain. Okay. And other bodies. This is inlet number one. I'm sorry, Now here is inlet number 2. And it's gonna be in stagnation conditions. Show all bodies. Hide all other bodies. This is the rotating domain. And interface number 2. Okay, show all bodies and close the mesh. We're gonna use the same procedure, update and save your work, please. Okay, let's open the setup. Precision. Repeat the same calculations, but you have to change the dimensions. Models, okay, epsilon, treatment, realizable, materials air, rotating domain, mesh motion, here's 3.33, boundary conditions for inlet number 1. Five, and I do not know the turbine intensity you have. Please check out the research paper. I'm not sure of it. Maybe more than 0.1. So the other diameter is the chord is according being like that. This is the chord, and also the outlet 0 and. And the interfaces, reference values. Here we have the chord, okay, and I think it's gonna be 24 blades or 25. And screen 20. It's gonna be 2 square meter. So the chord is multiplied by the height, multiplied by the number of the vanes. Okay, I'm not sure if they are 24 or 25. Okay, it's gonna be around 2 square meter, and here is the length. Gentlemen, before I forget, you have to create name selection for the airfoils for the CM values, okay? Here, please, you can open the mesh, and you have to make name selection for every airfoil. for the performance data. Something like that. Right, all other bodies. Be careful that you have to select or choose the inside faces. We have here four faces for every airfoil, or I'm sorry, for every blade. It's kind of tricky. Have to zoom in. Yes. No. It's very thin. Yes. And this. Make sure that they are, you selected the all in selection blade one. Blade one, three faces. Be sure that there are three faces, not four faces. This face. Yes, and there is another face. Ah, I think there are four faces, not three. So it's really not easy. This and the fourth and this is the fourth, so it's gonna be blade two. And here you have to add the face number four. So there are four faces. So please repeat this for the every blade, and to have the full blades. Okay. And then please reopen Fluent and re-add the data. And here the boundary conditions, the wall of the fixed domain has to be specified shear 0, and specified shear is gonna be 0. Okay, and the reference value is 2 square meter, and here we go, and you will find here the boundary conditions, the 24 or 25 blades. And make sure that the wall of them no slip. And check out these and the controls and the monitor. Please create drag and lift and the moment for exactly like what I did. And the activities and then the time step. And the initialization. Okay, calculate. Okay, initialize. Solution initialization. Hybrid. Initialize. The convergence is very good. Calculate. Here is the convergence. I used the enclosure method, but the convergence is very bad and it did not work. Okay, after finishing the analysis, you can open CFD post to check out the results, and you can make carry out the animation files. I have here the results of another simulation. For the inlet number 2, please, I have here 2 inlets. For inlet number 2, it's gonna be stagnant, and please, you have to make everything okay. And here, you can make the hydraulic diameter of the cord, and I'm not sure of this. You can make it the cord or the characteristic diameter of the pipe, but I'm not sure. Okay, and just the reference, and please recalculation. And here is the data with the animation files. I created it, and here is the data like this. Okay, and here the pipe was a small pipe. Notice that there is the suction, the air is being sucked from here and enters the turbine and exit. Okay, and here the animation, you can make it. Okay, gentlemen, thank you very much for watching this tutorial, and I hope it works with you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa ta'ala.